Welcome to CNS Inspire series of interviews featuring conversations with people who have made commendable contribution over the years for health and development justice. Each interview of CNS Inspire series explores what went well and not so well in the past 10-20 years and how can we accelerate progress towards not only issue-specific goals and targets but also for integrated development of all. From small and humble beginnings come great things. This sums up the illustrious journey spanning over 30 years of Dr. K.K. Chopra in fight against tuberculosis in India's capital, Delhi. Dr. K.K. Chopra is the director of New Delhi TB Center since over 5 years now. He spoke to CNS at the sidelines of a meeting to shape India's national strategic plan for next few years to accelerate the fight to end TB by 2030 or earlier. Without any further ado, let's listen to Dr. K.K. Chopra. Dr. Chopra, welcome. Fight against TB has been daunting. Please share with us what are the top three game changers that happened in the fight against TB over the last 2 decades or more, which has helped accelerate progress towards ending TB.
Yes, there has been a long journey. When I was a postgraduate student, we used to practice that domiciliary treatment. At that time, that was National TB Program. When treatment was based on X-ray examination and we used to give treatment for 2 years. It was famous 90 injections. We used to ask the history of the patient, whether you took 90 injections to identify that patient has taken treatment. So 90 injections treatment for treatment 1 and 2 years, that was the norm. Short course chemotherapy was just started and this was the routinely drugs being used and diagnosis was mainly based on the X-ray examination. Though there was a reporting mechanism, but at national level, there was not complete data available about the patients put on treatment, what has been their fate. Another point was that this was a district-based treatment, means there were one TB clinic in one district, and that district may be a population of 5 lakh or 20 lakh or even 40 lakh population, and there used to be one TB clinic, and patients used to go to that TB clinic every month to collect medicine, and we didn't know whether patient was completing treatment or not. They used to make one card of a treatment card of the patient. Any patient doesn't turn up to take treatment, after 1 week they used to send one postcard to the patient that treatment is due, please come to collect treatment. If patient then doesn't come, they used to send another card maybe after 21 days. Any patient doesn't come, they used to close that card. That was the mechanism. And when in the 90s, then the program was reviewed, it was found that with the help of X-ray, only 1/3 cases we were diagnosing. And out of the cases which were diagnosed and put on 2 years treatment, only 1/3 patient were completing the treatment. And by 30% detection and 1/3 patient completing the treatment, it was not making any epidemiological impact. Rather, absolute number of TB patients increased in 90s, till 90s, because of the population increase. So when the program was reviewed, so I have seen that era when domiciliary treatment, 2 year treatment, X-ray based treatment was continued. When the program was revised after 93 and expanded after 97, then with the help of this DOT strategy. So we have seen this DOT strategy, and this DOT strategy where diagnosis by sputum examination is more specific and treatment is short term, that is 6 months or 8 months. Program is doing fine. The what advantage, if I look back at the present, in 90s, late 90s, what we saw, the two advantages which I saw in the program was, one was this concept of patient-wise boxes. So there was regular supply, one box was made for each patient, and that box was used only for that patient. So if a patient was started on treatment, it was sure that patient was taking treatment. This was not the case in previous era. In previous era, in NTP era, it was hardly a few days where we got all the three drugs like streptomycin, INH and thiacetazine. At any time, either one of the three drugs were missing. And patient doesn't used to buy the medicine from market. So they used to take two medicine or one medicine which was available. That was the reason why patient used to discontinue treatment in between. So if you ask me the advantage of this new RNTCP program, first and foremost is that is availability of regular good quality medicine in the form of patient-wise boxes, and second is the default retrieval. Now we have got DOT centers like in Delhi. If we see, there were only 10 chest clinics at the time of NTP. Now there are 25 chest clinics, with 500 dot centers, 500 dot providers. So there is specific population a dot provider is catering to, and the patient doesn't come to take medicine, our dot provider makes visit to the patient on the same day or the next day, gives him health education and brings the patient back to the table. So these are the two major advantages which this NTP brought, RNTCP brought, as compared to the NTP program. And we have found that now there are more than 85% cure rate we are getting, and more than 85% patients are completing the treatment. Then this RNTCP made progress, and then came DOT plus or PMDT, embryo treatment. So previously drugs were not available, and we are finding after 2008 there has been rapid progress in MDR treatment also. Now we have got regular treatment for MDR also. The only negative point seen is the number of MDR cases now are increasing. Maybe we have got now better diagnostic facilities. So patients who were not being diagnosed in private sector or outside the program, now we are able to diagnose them. And another main breakthrough has been the rapid TB diagnostics. Like in previously we used to take 3 to 4 months to diagnose an MDR case. Now I am able to diagnose an MDR case within 2 hours. So same day if I am suspecting a patient to be MDR TB, same day by evening I am able to make the diagnosis, and next day patient can put on treatment. So this has been a game changer. So these three game changes are regular good quality drug supply, prompt patient default retrieval, and third is the rapid diagnostics. We are able to diagnose the patient within a day and put the patient on treatment within 2-3 days. So we are not losing the patient in between the period where patient are coming to the program and being diagnosed and put on treatment. So there, all the delays, which was because of the program or maybe because of the patient, that has tremendously decreased.
Thank you, Dr. Chopra. Please share some things we could have done better in this battle against TB in the past few years.
All these programmatic changes which has happened throughout this NTP, RNTCP, based on the available infrastructure, available finances, available manpower, I think the journey has been fruitful and effective also. The only negative point which I can perceive is the there has been no any new TB drugs, because we definitely want to reduce the duration of treatment, which we have not been able to do. But now, a few months back, we have got WHO endorsement for a short course MDR TB regime, 9 months regime instead of 27 months. That is another breakthrough which we have got, which I think has been a bit delayed. It could have been a few years early, so we could have taken care of that MDR menace which now we are perceiving, maybe a few years ago. Another is the new drugs. Now, bedaquiline and enalapril, two drugs which have been introduced in the program. Betaquiline has already been introduced in the program, and lenalidomide will be introduced, which is the project stage. Now these two drugs which have decreased the duration of treatment as well as increased the success rate. Till now MDR success rate we are getting only 50%, and we hope with the help of these introduction of new drugs, maybe we might be able to get a cure rate of 70-80%. So these two initiatives, it could have been come a few years earlier also, so that we could have not faced this MDR menace which we are facing it today. We have got treatment for pediatric age group before that, and there was some apprehension about the life shelf life of the pediatric formulation as well as viability of the drugs. Now these have been taken care, and recently the drugs have been introduced, and they are in the pipeline, in the production and introduction of the program. We will be not introducing this as syrup but as dispersible tablets. Now dispersible tablets will be introduced in the patient for the pediatric age group. Weight band which previously used to be 3, now we have got 5 weight band, so that there could be adequate dose, neither under or overdose nor overdose for the pediatric age group patients.
Looking ahead, Dr. Chopra, please share how can we further scale up the pace of TB decline to end tuberculosis by 2030.
That is a dream of the country to stop TB or to maybe not eliminate, completely cure the control the tuberculosis situation in India by 2030. The two to three things which we have to do, because recently we have got a recent data that more than 50% patients are in the private sector also. So there is a large number of patients in private sector. There have been efforts to take the care of the patients who are in the private sector also. And now in this new strategic plan, we are focusing more on this. that we make some interfaces or make a public-private mixed program so that we can take care of the patients who are in the private sector. Let them be the private sector. We will strengthen our private sector. We will give them health education. We will build the capacity of private practitioners to treat those patients more effectively. Maybe from the government side, we will give help in the form of logistics, diagnostics, and maybe we give free drugs to the patient even in the private sector. We have tried in three districts like Patna, Mumbai, and Mehsana, you might have heard, where, Mehsana, where the, we have given drug vouchers. So any patient who is being treated by private practitioner, we are giving free drugs through private practitioner. So that patient remain with the doctor of their faith and continue the treatment regularly. That has given good results. And now we are introducing it throughout our country, this type project, so that we can take care of the patient who is in the private sector. Another aspect which is coming recently is not only the drugs are needed to cure the patient, we need nutritional support, social psychosocial support also, and support in form of some incentives or some insurance type. And another very important is the rehabilitation of patient of TB. TB patients, sometimes they get crippled even after the treatment, they got their physical activity decreased. So we want to rehabilitate them so that there are no relapses in future also. So, and on that, those lines also we are taking care of in this new strategic plan which we will introduce recently. So these are the few things which we are thinking of. Every doctor, new budding doctor, he thinks he is a clinician. But in a field like tuberculosis, or maybe you can say in any field, there is a public health responsibility also. It's good that I will be very happy if I treat one patient. Clinically, I will be very happy that I have given him good advice. I have guided him. He has completed his treatment and he is cured of treatment. That is good. But what we have to think of? We have to think of the community, society as a nation also. And doctors are not only clinicians, they are public health experts also. So we have to take this responsibility as a public health expert. So if I treat one doctor, I think it will be better if I build the capacity of some new doctors put to treating. So if I build the capacity of 10 doctors who are working under me, and I make them to realize that they are clinician, good, that at first base they are clinician, but they are also public health experts also. So they should take it public health responsibility also. So we have to build up the capacity of other doctors, our younger doctors, our new generation. Even in the curriculum, I think there should be made some changes that public health responsibility and public health actions which we have to take to be taken by any doctor of any field, maybe Ayurveda doctor, maybe homeopathy doctor, I say even pharmacist, even a chemist. Suppose there is a chemist, he knows that if a patient comes to take him, medicines from him, like he is taking drugs for that some cough syrup or some drugs like antibiotics, and he is coughing or and he is taking frequently these drugs, he can be a case of TB. So if that community pharmacist, a pharmacist in a locality, if he thinks he may be a case of TB, and he just guides him to some dot center which are available nearby, that is a public health responsibility, not only for doctors, even for pharmacists, even for ASHA worker, even for ANM. I say any doctor, any field, you should take this responsibility for TBs. Even in the private sector or young doctors, they are not aware of the facilities available. Whenever I go to some community center, I always tell, if I go to some chest clinic and talk to some doctor, I tell the district TB officer that tell them what are the facilities available. Maybe a doctor is sitting in a hospital, he doesn't know two, three buildings away, there is a dot center. So what we have to make popular, our dot centers availability, our free diagnosing and treatment facilities which are available, which are good quality drugs and good quality, and they are quality assured diagnostic as well as drugs. So these should be popularized, and people as well as doctors should be motivated to utilize these facilities. We have got an infrastructure in our country. We have got very good infrastructure. More than 5 lakh dot centers are there in the country. Diagnostic centers in the country, so much. So if they are utilized, if they are utilized properly, we can definitely control tuberculosis within few years. The only thing is, we have to make the public utilize the existing which are available. There are many schemes available for the this type of chronic patients, like cancer patient, like TB patient. People are not aware, doctors are not aware, so they do not motivate the patients who take up that facility. So we have to popularize. Even that should be the responsibility of every doctor or every TB expert or at managerial level. This is our responsibility, that we should popularize these schemes, these facilities which are existing, how to utilize them. And if somebody comes, we have to guide them to properly use these facilities.
CNS had met Dr. Chopra 4 years ago, and he was planning a study to address tuberculosis in prisons then. Dr. Chopra, please share more on the progress on addressing tuberculosis in prisons.
This study is under progress. We have to initiate. We have done the initial work. We have sensitized the staff, nurses, doctors, and paramedical staff, which is available in Delhi. And
in the prison, sir.
In the prison, we have sensitized. We have put up a dot com microscopy center also there, and we have talked to the authorities also. They have agreed to allow us to conduct this study, and shortly we are starting this study. But we will do two things. First thing is, we will try to generate awareness among the paramedical staff which is there in the jail. We will not put any other staff. We will utilize the staff which is already existing in the jail. They will identify the team suspects, team symptomatics, anybody having cough for 2 weeks. We already have got one dot center, and we will place their gene expert machine also. We have got link to that DDUHS clinic. So what we will do, we will collect sputum samples of all the inmates, ward by ward. We will have the help of a transporter to transport the sputum sample to DDUHS clinic. We will do by the test by the gene expert machine, which will not only diagnose TB, immediately within 2 hours we will get result whether he is a MDR or not. We will detect TB as well as if they are TB, they are MDR or not. Same day result will be given. The problem which we have identified in the jail is sometimes the inmates are not willing to tell that they have got cough. So we will take the help of the, we will make some monitors among the inmates of the jail so that they can identify symptomatics for us. Our staff will take samples from them, get it sputum done. To jail authorities, we will give the results. We have got dot center. Immediately, we will start the treatment. And second action which we have to take, there is a rapid turnover in the jail, because there are two types of convicts. One, those who are undergoing that punishment, and another, they are under trials. There is a lot of turnover for under trials. Every day, 100, 200 people are discharged from the jail. So at the time of release of the, we will have communication, or we will have dialogue with that persons who are available at the time of release of the inmates. So at that time, if patient is suffering from TB, we will properly refer that inmates. When he comes out of the jail, he will be referred to the dot center, which is nearby to the inmates' residence. So that after starting the treatment in jail, we will detect the patient, we'll put the treatment on patient on treatment. After that inmate is released from the jail, we will help that patient continue the treatment whenever he is away from the jail. Wonderful. So that he completes the treatment. Because nowadays this referral mechanism is not working properly. And our health system, our dot center doesn't get information. The patient, he started on treatment 2 days back and then released. So that mechanism of proper referral with the help of jail authorities, that's very important. So we are working on those lines.
All the best.
Thank you.
We were listening to Dr. K.K. Chopra, director of New Delhi TB Center in India's capital and a senior clinician and public health expert who has contributed over 3 decades in fight against TB. This interview is part of CNS Inspire series of interviews featuring conversations with people who have made commendable contribution over the years for development justice. Each interview of CNS Inspire series explores what went well and not so well in the past 10-20 years and how can we accelerate progress towards not only issue-specific goals and targets, but also for integrated development of all. For more details, be welcome to check out our website www.citizen-news.org. Thanks for listening and stay tuned for our next episode of CNS Inspire series. Goodbye.